Now we will discuss the steps of generalizing. Okay. So these steps we have already discussed while discussing the rules of debit and credit. Okay. So the steps are, first we have to ascertain the accounts involved in the transaction. That means we have to identify which all accounts involved in the transaction. Okay. Suppose Peter started a business with cash, 1 lakh. That means the Peter introduced 1 lakh into the business. Peter is an owner. Okay. So what are the accounts involved in it? We have to identify the accounts. In this transaction, the account involved are cash 1 lakh and capital 1 lakh. So these are the two accounts involved in the transaction. So this is the first step. Okay. Now we have to identify the nature of these accounts. Okay, for identification we can use the two approaches, modern approach as well as the traditional approach. If you are taking the modern approach, the capital come into the business. Okay, so capital is a classification. Then second one, cash. Cash is an asset of the business. So capital is capital and cash is an asset. So this is the nature of the determination of ascertainment of nature of accounts. Or if you are taking the traditional approach, cash is a real account and capital is a personal account. Capital is owner's amount, so it is a personal account. So this is the ascertainment of nature accounts. Then we have to decide whether it is debit or credit. So this is the third step, ascertaining whether it is debit or credit. So cash brought into the business as capital. So capital increases. So when the capital increases, the capital is to be credited. And cash is an asset, so asset increases, the asset is to be debited. So the journal is cash account is debited and capital account is credited. Okay, so cash, so in this transaction cash is debit and capital is credit. Okay, so this is the transaction. Now we can discuss the format of journal. Okay, the format of journal, first column date, particulars, ledger folio LF, debit and credit. Okay, so total 5 columns. And first column date. Date means the date of occurrence of the transaction. Suppose we are investing the amount into the business and the date is 1st April. So we have to write 1st April. April 1. Okay. Then we have to record the accounts involved in here. Okay. When you are recording the accounts in the journal, first we have to write the debit account which is being debited, and second we have to write the account which is being credited. So first we have to write the account which is being debited. So in our transaction, the cash is the account which is debited. So we have to write cash account debit. Okay. You have to write cash account debit. Okay. Then we have to write the account which is being credited. So when you are writing the account which is being credited, we have to write like this. 2. 2 means credit. Okay. 2 capital account. So this debit shows debit balance and this 2 shows it is being credited. So the journal entry is cash account debit to capital. To capital means capital is being credited. Okay. Then we have to write the narration. Narration means what is the transaction. So for writing the narration, we have to write like this. Being. First we have to write being. Being cash brought as capital. So what is the transaction? That transaction we have to write as narration. Being cash brought us capital. Okay, or being started business with cash. Either you can write like this or like this. Okay. So journal, cash account, debit to capital. Capital account. Then ledger folio means the page in the ledger book in which that this transaction, these accounts are being entered. Okay, the page in which the in the ledger book this accounts are being recorded. Okay, suppose the cash account is being recorded in the 50th page of the ledger book, then we have to write here 50. Okay, and if the capital account is being recorded in the 85th page, then we have to write here 85. Okay, this we will study it later. Okay, so ledger folio means the page in which this account is being recorded in the ledger. Ledger means another book, we will study it later. Okay, then what is the cash involved here? The cash invested was 1 lakh. So in the debit column we have to write 1 lakh straight to cash. Straight to cash we have to write in the debit column 1 lakh, because cash is being debited, so in the debit column 1 lakh. And now the capital is being credited, so we have to record that capital value in the credit column, straight to capital account. So straight to here we have to record capital in the credit column. Okay, since the cash is being debited, the cash is to be recorded in the debit column, and capital is being credited, it is to be recorded in the credit column. So the journal entry is cash account debit 1 lakh to capital account 1 lakh. Okay, so this is a journal, and we will prepare it continuous for the remaining transactions. Okay, so this is a format of journal. Okay, clear?